entertain vitthanam or anybody under, can entertain vitthanam or renunciation, etam vaitam atmanam viditva vitthayatha vikshacharyam charodi. So vishesha vachanat means the vitthanam or the renunciation is qualified by the need of this knowledge. Then says Anandagiri, prageva vedanam siddham chet kim puna vitthanena iti. You say viditva vitthaya, having known the Atma, then you renounce. Prageva vedanam siddham chet, if before renunciation the person already has the knowledge of the Atma, kim puna vitthanena, then what is further to be accomplished by renunciation? If already he has the knowledge of the Self, what more is to be accomplished by the vitthaya renunciation? Iti vitthanena iti asankhya. Prayojaka jnanam. See, Bhashyakara actually comments upon that vakya here in the form of this question answer. Actually, Bhashyakara is only explaining that vakya. Etam vaitam atmanam viditvya in vitthanam. So, vitthaya, that vakya alone is being explained by Bhashyakara. So, question is, what is the nature of that knowledge? So, prayojaka jnanam. So, what is that knowledge which actually motivates one to take up the life of renunciate? Is it the Atma Vidya in the sense of Paroksha Jnanam or what? So says, Prayojaka Jnanam, Tat Prayojakam, Uddeshyam Tu Tattva Sakshatkaranam. For renunciation, there is a Prayojaka and there is an Uddeshya. Prayojaka is that which makes renunciation possible, and Uddeshya is that for which renunciation is taken. So that which is cause of renunciation is called Prayojaka Jnanam. And that for which one renounces is called Uddeshya. Uddeshya means the goal. So, Tat Prayojaka Jnanam, Tat Prayojakam, footnote numbers 8 and 9, there on that page. Apada Jnanam, Paroksha Jnanam va. Apada Jnanam is a general knowledge. Paroksha Jnanam is better knowledge. So, Apada Jnanam is that you did this Veda Pathanam and that's why you generally came to know. But there were strong samskaras, so even that was enough. You know, so everybody doesn't need every amount of motivation, or every amount motivation is okay, but everybody does not need the same amount of external pressure, you know, or external compulsion. So if samskaras are there, even one sentence may be enough for somebody like Jnaneshwar or somebody to run away, you know. So what is it? Then they say, Savdhan, Savdhan, you know, this fellow became Savdhan. Ramdas Swami, nah, Ramdas Swami. Jnandeva did not even have to bother Ram. He just went away, you know. So he became Savdhan. That was enough. And so, but something is that is Prayojaka Jnanam. That knowledge is Savdhan. Wait a minute, I have to become Savdhan. What am I doing here? And so he just walked away. But that is Prayojaka Jnanam. But why did he walk away? Because he wanted some, there is some part of Uddeshya is there. So, Prayojaka Jnanam, Tat Prayojakam, Vyutthana Prayojakam. So, it is Paroksha Jnanam or Apada Jnanam is the Prayojakam. It becomes the cause or Hetu or Nimitta Hetu for the Vyutthana renunciation. Uddeshyam Tu Tattva Sakshatkaranam, Uddeshyam Vyutthana Uddeshyam. But what is actually the objective, the purpose of the renunciation is Tattva Sakshatkaranam. That means now Bhashyakara says that Vedanam or the knowledge is twofold. One is Prayojaka Jnanam, other is Tattva Sakshatkaranam. Iti Vivakshitva Aha. So with that is the intention of saying, Bhashyakara says, Aha, Tasmadhi. Bhashyakara does not use these words. So what Bhashyakara says then further, so the commentators and subsequent acharyas have deliberated upon that and have come up with a nice model, you know, or terminology. So a terminology gets developed in course of time. Maybe Vashyakara also may use the word somewhere, but here we don't find that word Prayojaka Jnanam etc. being used. But naturally that's what it means. So that's why Vivakshitva. That Prayojaka Jnanam of renunciation is Paroksha Jnanam or Apada Jnanam. And the Uddeshya is Tattva Sakshatkara. So two kind of knowledge are there. So Dvedha Vibhajanam. That's what Vartyakara said. Dvedha. Tasmat, Subhashya says, Tasmat, ಮಾತೃಭ್ಯೋಪಿ ಏತೆಭ್ಯ ಅನಾತ್ಮಲೋಕ ಪ್ರಾಪ್ತಿ ಸಾಧನೆಭ್ಯ ಏಷಣಾ ವಿಷಯೇಭ್ಯ ವ್ಯುತ್ಥಾಯ ತಸ್ಮಾತ್ ಪ್ರಯೋಜಕ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಪಂಚಮ್ಯರ್ಥ ತಸ್ಮಾತ್ ದಿ ಫಿಫ್ತ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವರ್ಡ್ ತತ್ ತಸ್ಮಾತ್ ತ್ರಿಭ್ಯಃ ಅಪಿ ಏತೇಭ್ಯಃ ಅನಾತ್ಮಲೋಕ ಪ್ರಾಪ್ತಿ ಸಾಧನೆಭ್ಯಃ ಏಷಣಾ ವಿಷಯೇಭ್ಯ ವ್ಯುತ್ಥಾಯ ಹಿಯರ್ ತಸ್ಮಾತ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಮೀನ್ ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ತಸ್ಮಾತ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ Again, on the strength of that knowledge, tasmat tat sarvam abhavat. By virtue of that knowledge, you become everything. Similarly, tasmat, so by virtue of that knowledge, paroksha jnanam or apada jnanam, tribhyo vedebhya, anatma loka prapti sadhanebhya, eshana vishayabhya, vithaya. So based on that knowledge, so it is very clear, Vedantic teachers are very clear, that renunciation must be, or vairagya, must be a product of viveka, discrimination. It is one has performed the discriminative deliberation because of which the dispassion has arisen, and dispassion is not a reaction. It is not that some kind of an experience or situation in life has made a person give up things. That is not called dispassion. That may be, that is also a reaction of some kind. Dispassion is freedom from passion. And all passions are because of lack of viveka. It is lack of viveka or lack of discrimination that brings about a passion of one kind or the other. Not knowing the thing for what it is brings about passion. So not knowing what this is, to take this to be real, this pomegranate or whatever, you know. So take this is unreal stuff. Now I come to know this is made of wax actually, you know. That's why it is so light. The reason why it is so light is because it is made of wax. But anyway, not knowing the true nature of this object, like when I look at it, and when I'm hungry, of course, for passion to be created also, something there must be there inside. It's not that everything in the world creates passion in me. But I'm hungry. And then this, I happen to see this. Then there is an impulse in me to eat it, to appease my hunger. And that in turn produces an udyama, activity in the form of acquiring that thing, you know. And then if I cannot acquire it by fair means, I might do whatever is required, you know. So unfair means also may be employed. So all this Vihita and Pratishiddha karma, all that udyama, that activity, is a result of some or the other passion. the need to appease that passion. But then how did the passion arise in the first place? Because I do not know what this thing is. So Ramaniyatva, Aropa is there. And so I perceived that this is a means of fulfilling some of my need. And so that is lack of viveka, that any object of the world can solve a problem centered upon the self. That is aviveka. That objects of the world can solve my problems, all right, but then problems based on non-self. So prakriti-based problems can be solved by prakriti. Purusha-based problems can't be solved by prakriti, that's all. And what I come across and what I see and perceive and experience, all prakriti. And prakriti or matter cannot solve the spiritual problems. Matter can solve material problems. And we should know that the fundamental problem of a human being is a spiritual problem and not a material problem. Material problem is not a fundamental problem. It is only what we call the incidental problem or a topical problem. Material problem is a topical problem. Hungry, poor, illiterate, there are problems. And we have to address them. But all of these are what we call topical problems. That all of these situations become problems because a fundamental problem is there. Otherwise those things will not have become problems. That I am illiterate need not become a problem. There are people, illiterate, wise person also can be there who can be happy with what he is or she is. So nothing can become a problem. Even hunger also need not become a problem. Hunger is there, okay, you know, so you can be objective about it. That hunger will cause a physical pain, etc., is a different thing, but it need not become an emotional problem. All emotional problems are there, they are all centered upon spirit. All they are all spiritual problems, understand? All emotional problems are spiritual problems. And all other problems, physical problems, are all material problems. Of course, it's difficult to separate them, you know, where the body ends and where the mind starts, etc. And so that distinction need not be even made, but the point is that Sometimes, of course, when we learn more and more about what is happening to the mind and what are sorts of problems, then we find that other problems can also be there, physiological problems and chemical imbalances and all sorts of things. Ultimately, they are all spiritual problems, we would have to say. Because even that problem is not always 100%. It's not that it invariably happens. If something invariably happens, it is a material thing. That a person grows old is an invariable thing. That he develops wrinkles is an invariable thing. That he has grey hair, all this invariable stuff. Janma, mrityu, jara, vyadi, all of this is invariable. Where variable is there, then there is some unique, some individual input also is there. Whatever it is. But the thing is, that all, we would have to ultimately say, that all emotional problems have their source in the fundamental spiritual problem. And therefore, I cannot solve, even by chemical balances also, you can't solve that problem. You can get a relief, alright. Ultimately, what happens unfortunately is that when a chemical imbalance is there, one becomes incapable of applying that spiritual solution to that anyway. And so we require relief and whatever it is. Now that's out of place here. But the thing is that hoping the prakriti of the matter to solve my spiritual problem, first of all, recognizing what is a spiritual problem and what is a material problem, and that's one thing, and recognizing what matter can do, and then using the matter appropriately. Vedanta never says discard the matter, never says that. Or we should never understand that from what Vedanta says anyway, that it is not that world is to be discarded, or not that you to embrace the world either. And so world is useful. It has certain, things to offer. If I require them, I can go ahead and use it. If I don't require them, I need not have to acquire it also. But definitely, material world also has some significant, some important role to play in my life, and we respect it. But it cannot solve the spiritual problem, that's for sure. And therefore, I will not look upon food, or clothes, or house, or vehicle, or even wife and husband, or any even son and daughter, I will not look upon any of them as solving the spiritual problem. Solving the problem of emotional problem, etc. I will not look upon them. If I look upon them, I am developing further dependence. I can look upon them for whatever else, but otherwise. So that viveka, that discrimination is required. And then alone, the understanding that is created, and the subsequent relationship that is created out of that understanding is called vairagya. So vairagya also is not an action. Vairagya is nothing but that emotional maturity, meaning that healthy outlook that one has towards the world. So in fact, we think, people say that these fellows are all running away from the world and they do not know how to enjoy the world. But they are the only people who have the healthy outlook towards the world. Don't think people who are running towards the world are necessarily intelligent people, or that they are doing the right thing. So this is prayojika jnanam. Viveka jnanam, the vairagya born of viveka. Vairagya is a prayojika for renunciation, but vairagya itself is a product of viveka, or should be the product of viveka. So that is what is meant by tasmat. Tasmat, meaning prayojika jnanat, tribhyopete bhya, from all these three, anatma loka prapti sadhane bhya, eshana vishaye bhya vyutthaya. And therefore, growing out of these eshanas and the objects of eshanas, which are anatma loka prapti sadhane bhya, kim praja karishyama eshamna ayam atma ayam loka. So those who desire this atma as an atma loka, what do they have to do with these eshanas? They are all anatma loka prapti sadhane bhya. And so, all these are the means of attainment of what we call anatma loka, or the loka which is material loka. This material loka, even brahma loka, if it is a material loka, cannot solve spiritual problem. Problem based on spirit cannot be solved by any amount of material arrangement. Any kind of material arrangement is not adequate to solve the spiritual problem. This is all Vedantins are saying. They have nothing against brahma loka, nothing against any loka, nothing against any meditation, they have nothing against anything. But if you really want to solve the problem of life, then this is what it is. That all the lokas, all the way up to brahma loka, can only give you this, they can only give you material satisfaction, they cannot solve your spiritual problem. And human being is a spiritual being, not a material being. You know, somebody will ask, they always argue, Swami, but what do you call spirit or consciousness? Consciousness is a product of the chemical, you know, composition, the chemical combination in the brain and things like that. So that's how consciousness is there. I said, are you a spirit or matter? Tell me, that's all. I asked. He's not willing to accept that he's matter. I said, okay. If you're not matter, then you're spirit. So that's the consciousness we are talking about. Not the consciousness in terms of sensation. So consciousness means what? But the brain can create consciousness in terms of sensation. All right. So neurological nervous sensation, etc., can be created. That's fine. But by consciousness, that because of which you are even aware of the sensation, you know. So that is the consciousness of spirit that we are talking about.
इदानीं व्युत्थाय भिक्षाचर्यं चरन्ति इति सम्बन्धः एषणा विषयेभ्यः व्युत्थाय देन लेटर ऑन भिक्षाचर्यं चरन्ति सो यू टू कनेक्ट दिस वाक्य इज इनकम्प्लीट विदाउट अ वर्ब सो अनात्मलोक प्राप्ति साधनेभ्यः एषणा विषयेभ्यः व्युत्थाय भिक्षाचर्यं चरन्ति दैट विल कंप्लीट द सेंटेंस व्युत्थान स्वरूप प्रदर्शनार्थं एषणा स्वरूपमः
Vyutthana Swarup Pradarshanartham, in order to show what is the nature of Vyutthana. Vyutthana Swarup Pradarshanartham, in order to show us the Swarup or the nature of Vyutthana, Eshana Swarup Maha, we are being told. So what is meant by Vyutthana? Giving up the Eshanatraya. What is Vyutthana? Giving up the Eshanatraya, the threefold Eshanas. Then what is Eshana? That we should know. Therefore, Eshana Swarup Maha, Eshana iti, says Bhashyakara.
एषणा कामः एतावान् वै कामः इति श्रुतेः
एषणा मीन्स् कामः कामः इति काम्यः कामः मीन्स् डिसायर् काम्य मीन्स् ऑब्जेक्ट् ऑफ डिसायर् सो एषणा मीनिङ्ग् कामः डिसायर् और दि ऑब्जेक्ट्स् ऑफ डिसायर् एतावान् वै कामः इति श्रुतेः as we said the kama or the desire this is the scope of the desire that includes all the loka what has happened here is that in this threefold eshanas he said there is a confusion not a confusion but a mixture is there the three eshanas are there of which two eshanas are of the nature of sadhanam and one eshana is of the nature of sadhya the two are mixed up here so putra eshana and vitta eshana are eshanas or desires pertaining to sadhanam because putra vitta are sadhanam and loka eshana is the eshana pertaining to sadhya so that is kamya and therefore sadhya means kamya desired object so both these kinds are there ultimately eshana or the desire is always for the desired object and therefore the putta vitta that desires are secondary meaning by the way So, hitavan vikama means that ultimately the desire is for the loka, desire is for the three worlds, or whatever we understand as loka. I mean, those days, that is how they looked upon the world as made up of three lokas. Today we may look upon the world in a different way. In that case, I don't care for Swarga Swamiji, therefore I don't qualify for this. No, you may call for something else. You may want to go to Mars, you know, people are planning all kinds of things. People are planning, so already they have reserved space in the moon, on the moon, you know. And so real estate agents can do anything, you know. So they start selling real estate on moon. And afterwards they'll start selling real estate on Mars, you know. And therefore, so that is your Brahma Loka or Swarga Loka, whatever it is. That means the definition of what Swarga is may change, but the fact that one wants some exclusive place and situation, that always remains. And so that is a loka.
किम एतावता इति आशंक्य व्युत्थान स्वरूपमः ऑल राइट सपोज एषणा इज काम सो व्हाट किम एतावता
दैट इज व्हाट एषणा स्वरूप प्रदर्शन मात्रेण किम आयातम बिकॉज एषणा मीन्स काम्य विषय एषणा मीन्स ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ डिजायर ऑल राइट सो दैट इज सो व्हाट व्हाट रेलेवेंस डज इट हैव विथ रेफरेंस टू व्युत्थान रेनन्सिएशन सो इति आशंक्य व्युत्थान स्वरूपमः भाष्यकर गिव्स द नेचर ऑफ रेनन्सिएशन एतस्मिन् इति
एतस्मिन् त्रिविधे अनात्मलोक प्राप्ति साधने तृष्णाम अकृत्वा इत्यर्थः। एतस्मिन् व्हाट इज व्युत्थानम्, व्हाट इज एनन्सिएशन, व्युत्थानम् इज भिक्षाचर्यम् चरन्ति कम्स लेटर ऑन। भिक्षाचर्यम् चरन्ति मीनिंग दे टेक अप टू द लाइफ ऑफ ए वैंडर और अ मेंडिकेंट, बट बिफोर भिक्षाचर्यम् व्युत्थाय हैविंग अराइजन फ्रॉम द डिजायर, मीनिंग व्हाट, एतस्मिन् त्रिविधे अनात्मलोक प्राप्ति साधने तृष्णाम अकृत्वा। This threefold means, which is a means of attainment of non-self, trishnam akrutva, becoming free from the trishna, the craving of the desire, for these threefold things, which are means of anatma. It also includes anatma loka prapti sadhana, but loka also is included in there anyway. Ultimate loka is sadhanam for pleasure, you can say, you know. So brahma loka also is a means of ultimately some sense gratification, some happiness, material pleasure. What is sambandhastu purvata? Meaning what? So, trishnam akrutva, bhikshacharyam charanti, again, akrutva, incomplete sentence. Akrutva, bhikshacharyam charanti. This is how the sentence is to be completed. Purvat. Purvat means like earlier, eshanavishayabhyavithaya bhikshacharyam charanti, same thing, trishnam akrutva, bhikshacharyam charanti. Okay. So, Bhashyakar has explained, एतम् वै तमात्मानं विदित्वा पुत्रेषणायाश्च वित्तेषणायाश्च लोकेषणायाश्च व्युत्थाय अथ भिक्षाचर्यं चरन्ति। देन् या ह्येव पुत्रेषणा सा वित्तेषणा, या वित्तेषणा सा लोकेषणा, उभयह्येते एषणे एव भवतः। दट् पैसेज नाउ, या ह्येव इत्यादि श्रुतेः तात्पर्यम्। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल भाषा गेहि तात्पर्य, द पर्पोज ऑफ दट पैसेज, सर्वा हेते सर्वाहि साधने इच्छा फलेच्छा एव अतः व्याचष्टे श्रुतिः एका एव एषणा इति। सर्वाहि साधने इच्छा फलेच्छा एव, अल्टीमेटली इवन ए डिजायर फॉर अ साधनम और मीन्स इज नथिंग बट डिजायर फॉर फल और द एंड, एज वी हैव बीन सेइंग, my desire to procure or make book my tickets for Delhi is because I want to travel in the train, and that again is sadhanam for reaching Delhi, that again may be sadhanam for reaching Rishikesh, that again may be sadhanam for attending a camp, that again may be sadhanam for studying Upanishad, that again may be a sadhanam for happiness, for freedom, that's all, then that is not sadhanam. So anyway, sarvahi sadhana iccha, any iccha or the desire for sadhanam or means is always brought about by phalechaiva, by a desire for phala. Ultimately some phala is there. So you must always, behind, whenever desire arises, you must always take it up to the last, you know, up to the end, as to all, why do you want this? I want to go to Delhi, why? So I can go to Rishikesh, why? So I can attend a camp, why? So I can study Upanishad, why? So I can get peace of mind. Okay. So ultimately booking ticket is a means of peace of mind. And so my desire for booking a ticket or going to a travel agent or standing in line, whatever, that udyama is all motivated by the ultimate end. Sarvahi sadhanecha, wherever there is a desire for sadhanam, phalecha eva, all of them are nothing but the another form of phalecha. It is a phalecha that becomes sadhanecha. That phalecha ultimately becomes sadhanecha. Otherwise, everyday trains are going to millions of places. Who cares, you know? All of a sudden, a given train becomes important. What happens? When does that train leave, you know? On what days? And where does it go? When does it reach? Why does it all become important to you? All of a sudden? Because I want to go to Coimbatore or whatever, you know. Why, you know? Anyway, so ultimately, it is that phalecha that gets transformed as sadhanecha. Sadhanecha is nothing but another phalecha appearing in a different guise, that's all. Sarvai sadhanecha phalecha eva. Sri Anandagiri, phalam naichadi sadhanam cha chikirshadi idi vyaghatat. Phalam naichadi, he doesn't want to accomplish anything. Sadhanam cha chikirshadi, but he wants to do something.
So he adopts a certain means, all right. He is doing some udyama, all right, without designing any end. Iti vyaghatat. That cannot be. So this is a fundamental law of the mind. Prayojanam anuddishya namandobi pravartate. That not even a dull-witted person will ever proceed to do anything unless a prayojanam or some purpose is to be accomplished. And so he has no purpose and still is doing something. Some people do things purposelessly, but that itself is a purpose. Sometimes, you know, that itself becomes a purpose. What is it? That's all right. I just want to take a walk, that's all. No purpose. Or whatever. And so that becomes a purpose because not doing it is difficult, you know, it makes him perhaps uncomfortable. So therefore, to get some comfort, you know, you do something. And so to become free from discomfort, you do something which doing may not have any external purpose. An internal purpose is then becoming free from discomfort, all right. In which process he may create discomfort of others, that's a different matter. But then, so some purpose is always there. If you think about it, then some purpose is always there.
So Anandagiri says, phale chanta bhutayo sadhanecha. So sadhanecha, meaning desire for sadhanam, always is included in the phalecha. Antarbhuta. Tadyuktam eshna ekyamityartha. And therefore, it is quite right to say that eshna ultimately is only one, and that is phalecha. Eshna or phalam is only eshna. Therefore, Vahashyakara says, ataha vyachaste shrutihi eka eshna eva. And so, therefore, Shruti says, sadhanechaya phalecha rupatvat. Since sadhanecha is nothing but another form of phalecha, therefore Shruti says that this is eshana is one alone. Etavan vai kamaha. Desire only is one and not many. Sri Ranagiri Shrutehe tadaikya vyutpadakatvam prasnapurukam vyutpadayati. Shruti tadaikya vyutpadak. Shruti herself gives the vyutpatti or upapatti. So Shruti herself gives the reason why eshana is one. In order to explain that reason that the Shruti gives, prasna purvakam vyutpadayati. So that reason that the Shruti provides is provided by Bhashyakara with a question here. Kathamiti. So this is Bhashyam. This is on page 895. Katham yaheva patraishana savittaishana drashtaphala sadhanatva tulyatvat ya vittaishana sa lokaishana phala sa eva sa ya hi eva putraishana sa vittaishana. Footnote number 5. Ya iti yadi moola vakya vittham yojyam tathahi. You have to go back to that page in order to see what the moola vakya is. Ya hi eva putraishana sa vittaishana ya vitteshana sa lokeshana uvekhyete eshane eva bhavatah. That's the mool vakyam. So that is being explained by the tippani here. Idam ityadi mool vakyam ittham yojyam. Then mool vakya, meaning the shruti vakya, is to be understood in this manner. Because Vashyakara may not have clearly explained it, therefore tathahi, to show here, illustrate. Phalecha sadhanam upasankramatiti nyayat. So phalecha antarbhutayo sadhanecha anandagiri said. Here also, phalecha sadhanam upasankramati. So the desire of phala automatically includes the desire for sadhanam. Desire of end automatically includes the desire for means. Meaning that the desire for means is not to be considered as a separate desire. You don't count that as a separate desire. How many desires do you have? You said you wanted to go to Rishikesh. Now you want to go to Delhi also. And then you want to travel by this train also. So you must do booking also. Why this question? Because he wants 4 hours off. Why? So he can go to railway station and book his ticket. Then I ask him, why do you want to go? I want to go to railway station. So he wants to give up his work and wants to go to railway station. Why? So I can book my ticket. Why? So I can travel by train. Why? So I can go to Delhi. Why do you need all that stuff? I thought you just wanted to go to Rishikesh. Yeah, but I cannot do that. I cannot reach Rishikesh unless all of this is done. And so if I permit him to go to Rishikesh, I must give him permission for all the other stuff also.
It's not that I give him permission to go to Rishikesh, all right. Swami, I won't be in the class for 15 days. Wait a minute, why? Because I want to go to Rishikesh. No, forget it. Rishikesh you can go, but class you must come to. Now, you know, that cannot be. And so, when phalechcha is entertained, we must know that all other commitments are there. It's not easy. That phala cannot be accomplished unless all the sadhanas are also taken care of. It is nice to dwell upon the phala and be happy about enjoying it, but we must know what it entails. It entails lots of things, you know. It's better that one properly looks at what it all entails, you know. What udyama I have to do, and having done the udyama, what I am deprived of, what I get, we should also always think, along with what I get, what am I deprived of. That also is very important to ascertain, you know. Then perhaps that, because generally speaking, my mind always dwells upon what I will get and fails to take into account what price I have to pay. And so we must also take into account the price we have to pay. But Swami, if you keep thinking like that, you will never do anything. Then don't do anything. If by thinking alone, you know, if the conviction arises, then don't do anything. But then thinking sometimes does not eliminate fascination. What happens is, merely knowing, technically speaking, that all the happiness, all the material pleasures, you know, they're all mithya, etc. Still the desire for eating ice cream continues there, you know. But somehow that does not go. So then it's a habitual thing which requires to be dealt with at that level. Habitual means a set pattern of thinking. A thinking pattern is set in there for which no deliberation is required. Then I must deliberate. Because having deliberated in a given way in the past, therefore this pattern has arisen, and now I don't have to deliberate. But to remove that pattern, I will deliberate in a manner reverse from what I deliberated in the past. As a child, I deliberated that ice cream is the best thing in the world to have. Every day I would think, and so that fascination or craving for ice cream has become just habitual. As an adult now, I must deliberate more upon ice cream. As to where it comes from, how it is made, beginning from there. What it does to my stomach, and to my throat, and to my mind, and to my spirit, that is more important. But in case that is not adequate, you must also go and see where the ice cream is made, in what manner it is made, when it was made, and everything else, you know. And so, everything, perhaps even that may be enough to discourage you to eat ice cream or shikhand or anything like that, anyway. And so, we must also take into account all the price that we have to pay, you know, for. I'm not saying don't eat ice cream or chicken, but I'm saying that. So, thing is that one must take into account everything that is involved there, you see. So, idea is that phalecha sadhanam upasankramati, that phala cannot be accomplished unless all the sadhanas are also implemented, that we should know. Going to the footnote, phalecha sadhana upasankramati iti nyaya, this is nyaya. Lokeshana eka ityaha, lokeshana eva eka ityaha. Inasmuch as other two eshanas are sadhanecha, and therefore they are already included in the phalecha, which is lokeshana, so ultimately only one eshana is there, which is lokeshana, meaning which is the eshana or the desire for the end. In this case, swarga loka, etc. Yahiti. So says the Tika. He prasiddha, something that is well known. Prasiddhaya putreshana, that is which is well known as a putreshana. Saya vitreshana, that putreshana also is nothing different from vitreshana. In fact, those eshanas are different. I don't think that you can equate them, that putreshana is the same as vitreshana. Not really. But putreshana also is sadhaneshana. And sadhaneshana and vitreshana also is sadhaneshana. In that sense, they are equal. That both of them are sadhanam, in that sense, they fall in the same category. Therefore, you can equate them. But sarku, it's all the same. Sarku doesn't mean that they are identical. The same stuff, you know. All right, Swami, you don't need ice cream. Here is shrikant. Same stuff. You know what I mean? The idea is that. So, whatever that thing does, the other thing also does the same thing, you know. Anyway, Swami, all right. Now, ras, you know. Same stuff again. Go in and find out when the rust was actually, you know, when they extracted it, and how long it is sitting in the cold storage and everything else, and what preservatives have been added, and whatever it is. So it's same stuff, you know. It's not that the chicken is the same as ice cream, that is same as rust. I don't mean that. But same stuff means they fall in the same category. That's the idea, yeah, anyway. And so, in that sense, this putra ishana and vitta ishana is equated. Not that the desire for putra is the desire for vitta. Or not that what putra does is what vitta does. That also is not right. But both are desires which do not serve a purpose in themselves, through which we intend some other purpose to be served. Meaning that one does not want vitta for the sake of vitta. One wants vitta for the sake of something else, for atma. That is what is meant by atma sukamaya saram prem bhavati. Everything becomes dear for the self, meaning self being the spirit. So since that everything is nothing but is looked upon as a solution of spiritual problem, all of these things become dear to me because I look upon them as hoping as a means of solving my spiritual problem, which is not the case. But anyway, so ultimately what we call putra and vitta, all of them are meant for one goal is the same. And goal is that loka. In that sense, they are the same. Not that putra and vitta are identical, or putra does the same thing as vitta, no. But both of them are means for attainment of loka. Therefore, they are equated. Saya putreshana, saya vitreshana, drishtafalatva sadhana adi samanya. Drishtafalatva sadhanatvam. So, the drishtafala is what? Loka. So, they are means of attainment of loka. And that is how drishtafalatva sadhana adi samanya. So, drishtafalatva sadhanatva adi samanya. That both of them are sadhanam for drishtafala. So, first is, ya heva putreshana, sa lokeshana. Ya lokeshana, ya putreshana, sa lokeshana. It's not that putreshana is lokeshana. But now putreshana is the same as vitreshana also. So putreshana and vitreshana are sadhaneshana. And that is the same as sadhyeshana, that is what is meant. So ya putreshana ya ekatmapanna vitreshana. So first putreshana is equated to A, is equated to B. Then B is equated to C. Therefore B is now the same as A. And so A, which is B, is the same as C. In a way. So putreshanayaha. So putreshana, na putreshanaya. Saha ekatma apanna ya vitreshana. So now the vitreshana. So putreshana was equated to vitreshana. So vitreshana now has attained a state of being one with same as putreshana. And so sa lokeshana eva. And that vitreshana is nothing but lokeshana eva. Why? Sadhyaloka eshana prayuktatvat. Because that vitteshana, which also includes putreshana, both of them are means for sadhya. Sadhya lokeshana. Sadhya lokeshana means sadhya which is loka. So loka there is sadhya of for which there is an eshana. So sadhya rupa lokeshana prayuktatvat. Or prayojya prayojaka aikya abhipraya. The idea is the means and ends are equated here. Prayojya and prayojaka. So prayojya is sadhaneshana, prayojaka is sadhyeshana. Meaning the desire for swarga becomes the prayojaka. And that which is prayojya is what we agnihotra, adi karma, etc. Then says sadhaneshanayaha evam ekatvebi lokeshanayaha sadhanamantarena asiddhahe sadhya sadhanabhedena dvaividhyam aha. Still some dvaividhya meaning, they remain different. Sadhaneshana yahayam ekatvebi, even though the putreshana and vitreshana, both of them are one because both of them are sadhanam or the means, still. Lokeshana yaha sadhanam, sadhanamantarena siddhehe. But lokeshana is not in the same category as vitreshana, putreshana because lokeshana cannot be independently pursued. See, vitreshana I can pursue independent of lokeshana. And putreshana also I can pursue, putra also I can pursue. But lokeshana I cannot pursue in absence of putreshana and vitra and vitta. So, lokeshana yaha sadhanamantarena asiddhehe. That unless I adopt the sadhanam of the nature of putra and vitra, that lokeshana, swarga, etc. cannot be accomplished. Therefore, sadhya sadhana bhedena dvaividhyam. So in that sense, eshana is one and still two. Sadhaneshana, sadhaneshana and sadhyeshana. So ubheshyete eshana. So then again Shruti is ubheshyete. Both of these are nothing but eshanas. So on one hand it is said eshana is one alone, and still Shruti says both of these are eshanas. Both means what? Sadhana eshana, eshana and sadhya eshana. So
So that Tika says, he yasmat ube ede sadhya sadhana rupe eshana eva bhavata iti. Because both of these are eshanas, there is a slight difference. The pot is nothing but the clay. But still, clay is the cause and pot is the effect. In that sense, a certain distinction or difference between them is accepted. Similarly also here, the one is prayojaka, other is prayojya. So, the prayojya cannot be without prayojaka and vice versa, and still, some difference we accept here. Inasmuch as the prayojya can be there and prayojaka may not be there. Meaning that, I may acquire the sun all right. You know, so sun I may acquire all right, so that I can win this world. And that may not happen. Depends on how that sun turns out to be. You know, and therefore, I might lose 7 worlds. Not only that I will not acquire this world, but by what he does, I may never acquire any world. You know, that can happen. Or vitta also. And so, depends on what kind of vitta I have, that somehow the vitta comes and distracts me. I want to acquire vitta so I can perform agnihotradi karma or some kind of religious activities I can perform. But vitta itself is such a fascination that religion has gone away from my life, you know. And so, looking at all kinds of consumer goods available, I get so distracted that the very desire or purpose for which the vitta was acquired may have gone away. So, therefore, the prayojya, meaning that loka or the sadhya or the end may not be accomplished even by accomplishing means. So, there being that uncertainty or that difference is there, in that sense, Shruti accepts them as two different ashanas, sadhya ashana and sadhana ashana. So, going back to Bhashya, yaheva putra ashana, sa vitta ashana, dushta prasadhanatva tulyatvat. Sixth footnote, dushta ityadi. Putra vitta ishana yoho mitho hetu hetu mad bhavacha ityami drashtavyam. Vistarastu vartike. All the vartika you have to study for all the vistara. They have not done it because he must have hundreds of verses to explain all this, which cannot be reproduced here, and which are fairly clear to us from the, based on discussion that came in the past, and therefore it is not reproduced here. But two reasons are there. Dushta prasadhanatva tulyatvat. Both of them are the means of drishtaphala, immediate ends, or the perceived ends. And adrushta, meaning atma in that case we have to say, so brahma vidya is a sadhanam for adrushtaphala. Adrushtaphala means not phalam that can be objectified, drishtaphala means a phala that can be objectified. That's how we do interpret. Secondly, putra vittayishana yo mitho hetu hetu mad bhavacha. That's interesting. That putraishana, so the desire for the sun and desire for the wealth are each one the cause for the other. Ityabhi drashtavyam. And that you have to think about, you know, as to how vittayishana is a means of putraishana and putraishana also is a cause for vittayishana. Each one causes the other, you know. It's true, if you want to have a son, then you require wealth because you can't support, you know, a son without wealth, I guess. Or, son alone is not enough, wealth is also required to perform karma. And that's how hetu hetu mad bhava must have been established in Vartika, I guess, you know, anyway. So, hetu hetu mad bhava means what? Each one is the cause of the other. That's called hetu hetu mad bhava. And so, we have to think about an example anyway. But, this famous story of Mullah Nasruddin is there, which we are told in the past, that once Mullah Nasruddin is walking alone in the evening, and there's a deserted street, and he sees 4 hefty, strong, tall people coming towards him and blocking his way and threatening. And this fellow was scared, so he ran away. He just jumped a wall. And that happened to be a graveyard, and he just ran away into the graveyard. And these 4 fellows saw this man, all of them running away. So they did not know what happened to him. So they thought maybe he needs some help, you know, whatever it is. So they ran after him. And so this fellow saw him there running after him, so he further ran. And then not finding any way to go, he saw an open grave and jumped into it, and he was lying down like this. And his 4 fellows came, looking down at him. He says, what brings you here? He says, on one hand, I can say that you bring me here. On the other hand, I bring you here, you know. And so, hetu hetu mad bhava. The mullah becomes a reason for these fellows to be there, and they become the reason for mullah to be there. This is the hetu hetu mad bhava. Hetu hetu mad means, hetu means cause, hetu mad means effect. What is cause also is an effect, and what is effect also is a cause. This kind of peculiar situation happens sometimes. Many situations are like that. In fact, every situation is like that. That is called samsara. But hetu hetu mad bhava is specifically used when
a given thing, one is a cause of this and that itself is a cause of this. That is hetu hetu madbhava. Otherwise, hetu phalatmaka samsara is there. Everything is a cause of something and everything is an effect of something. That is true. But when one thing is a cause of a given thing and that itself is a cause of this, then it is called hetu hetu madbhava. So apparently, putraishana becomes the cause of vittraishana and vittraishana becomes the cause of putraishana. Vistarastu vartike, this is what Vartikara explains. So that Drashtavyam, that also is the reason why both of them are looked upon as one Eshana alone. That Yahi, Yahyeva, Vittaishana, Putraishana, Sa Vittaishana, because of these two reasons there. Okay.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankara Keshavam Vadarayanam Sutta Bhashya Vande Bhagavanta Punah Punah. Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Deha Yajnavalkye Diho Vache Yadeva Sakshad Parokshad Brahma Ya Atma Sarvantaraha Tamme Vyachakshveti Eshata Atma Sarvantaraha Katamo Yajnavalkya Sarvantaraha Yoshanaya Pipase Jara Shokam Moham Jaram Ratyu Machyede Etam Vaitam Atmanam Viditva Brahmanah Putraishanayascha Vittaishanayascha Lokaishanayascha Vyutthaya Asa Vikshacharyam Charande Yahyeva Putraishana Sa Vittaishana Ya Vittaishana Sva Lokaishana Uvehyete Eshane Eva Bhavataha Tasmad Brahmana Panditya Nirvidya Tvanditya Nirvidya Balyena Tishthased Balyam Cha Panditya Nirvidya Samunihi Nityam Chana Amaunam Chamaunam Chana Nirvidyatha Brahmanaha Sab Brahmanah Kena Syad Yena Syate Nidrisha Eva Ato Nyadartam Tato Hakaho Lah Kaushita Keya Uparama Page 805, Yahyeva Ityadi Shrutis Tatparyamaha Sarvahi Sadhanicha Phalaichayava. So, Yahi Putraishana Savitraishana Yavitraishana Salokeshana. So, that Eshana for Putra is indeed the Eshana for Vitta, and that Eshana for Vitta is indeed the Eshana for Loka. Uvehyete Eshane Eva Bhavataha. Because both of these are nothing but Eshanas. And therefore, ultimately, all the Eshanas reduced to one Eshana. Sarvahi Sadhanecha, two Eshanas are there, actually, you can say. One is Eshana for Sadhya, other is the Eshana for Sadhanam. Sarvahi Sadhanecha, Phalecha, Phalecha Eva. All the Icha, the desire for Sadhanam, the means, ultimately are motivated from the desire for the Phala or the end. Ato Vyachaste Shrutihi. Eka eva eshana iti. And the Shruti says, eshana is really one alone. या ह्येव पुत्रैषण सा वित्तैषण दुष्टफलसाधनत्व तुल्यत्वात्। हाउ डू यू कंपेयर द पुत्रैषण विद वित्तैषण और वॉट एवर। सो दैट विच इज द डिजायर फॉर द सन इज द डिजायर फॉर वेल्थ। हाउ डू यू से नॉट दैट द टू डिजायर्स आर आइडेंटिकल और वन दृष्ट साधनत्व तुल्यत्वा देयर इज सम तुलना सम तुल्यत्वम समथिंग कॉमन और सिमिलर बिटवीन देम दृष्ट और साधनत्व तुल्यत्वा देन एज मच एज बोथ ऑफ देम आर द मीन्स दैट्स ऑल। सो पुत्र आल्सो द मीन्स एंड वित्त आल्सो द मीन्स दे आर नॉट द एंड इन देमसेल्व्स दे आर बोथ मेंट फॉर सम अचीवमेंट ऑफ सम अदर एंड दृष्ट फल एंड बोथ ऑफ देम ब्रिंग अबाउट अ रिजल्ट दैट इज दृष्टम और दैट इज immediate or that is known. So that's why footnote number 6 said putra vitteshanayo mithayo mitho, that's another thing, hetu hetu madbhava, that's a different thing again, that both of them are the cause for the other one and the effect of the other one. Ya vitteshana sa lokeshana falasaye vasa, and so again ya vitteshana sa lokeshana, whatever is the wealth, the desire for the wealth is ultimately desire for loka alone. Phalartha evasa samish putra vittad rupa rupa sadhaneshana phalartha eva. So putra and vitta rupa sadhana, so sadhaneshana and sadhya eshana. So this is how it was explained. We are on the page 806. सेदानगिरी फलैषणान्तरभावं साधनैषणायाः समर्थयते। फलैषणान्तरभावं साधनैषणायाः, हौ साधनैषण इज इन फैक्ट इन्क्लूडेड और इज अ पार्ट ऑफ द फलैषण इज इन्क्लूडेड इन द फलैषण अन्तर्भावं सर्वः इति सेज भाष्य सर्वः फलार्थप्रयुक्त एव हि सर्वं साधनमुपादत्ते अतः एका एव एषणा या लोकैषणा सा साधनमन्तरेण सम्पादयितुं न शक्यते इति साध्यसाधनभेदेन उभे हि यस्मात् एते एषणे एव भवतः तस्माद् ब्रह्मविदः नास्ति कर्म कर्मसाधनं वा। समर्थयते भाष्यकार हियर सपोर्ट्स विथ एन आर्ग्युमेंट सर्वः फलार्थ प्रयुक्तः एव हि सर्वं साधनम् उपादत्ते सर्वः एवरीवन ऑल पीपल फलार्थ प्रयुक्तः एव is prompted by a phalartha with a desire for an end. Sarvam sadhanam upadatte. So upadatte, whenever we undertake any kind of a sadhanam or a means, that is always because that is motivated by a desire for the end. This is a rule. So this is a general rule. No one can take up something without a desire to achieve something. Prayojanam anuddishya namandopi pravardate. Of course, the phala can be even Ishwararpana Buddhi, or so Ishwarasya Prasannata, that may the Lord be pleased by this. So some kind of phala is there, or at least the phala is because there is a desire inside to do something, not that there is a desire even to achieve something at personal end, but that's all. Looking at the situation, I feel like doing something. And so to satisfy that need to do something, also one does things. So even what we call nishkama karma or selfless actions, even for selfless actions also, there is a desire in the mind to do something. You see somebody in pain or suffering and therefore there is a desire to help, desire to do something. So, and he would be uncomfortable unless that desire is fulfilled and therefore, so then that is a desire to take care of that desire or to resolve that desire or to quieten that desire. So some end is always there. And thus, prompted by a desire to fulfill that end, one always takes up a sadhanam or a means. Ataha. See footnote number 2, ataha iti, सर्वस्यापि फलार्थित्वेनैव साधनोपादान दर्शनादित्यर्थः.
You can say that a Brahmanishtha or a Jnani perhaps is an exception to that, in as much as there is no desire whatever, he just, that is spontaneous. So for a wise man who is totally in tune with God, then since he is totally in tune with God, there is no attempt required on his part to do something or not do something. His action is totally spontaneous. You don't even call it action, but then he is totally a spontaneous person. So that, then there is no Aishana in him anyway. And so he is a Brahmanishtha. So he is free from all the desire. Of course, this is basically talked about the one who has desire. So this rule is applicable to ignorant people, that's why.
Sarasyavi phalartitve naiva sadhanopadana darshanat ataha.
Since we find that everybody takes up a means in order to achieve a certain end, therefore,
vartikeyatha. साध्यैषणा प्रयुक्तत्वात् पुत्र वित्तैषणात्मनः एका लोकैषणैवेयं त्रिधातो व्यपदिश्यते. साध्यैषणा प्रयुक्तत्वात् पुत्र वित्तैषणात्मनः.
सो दिस पुत्रैषणा वित्तैषणा साध्यैषणा प्रयुक्तत्वात्. सिंस दिस एक्चुअली दिस ऐषणात् आर ओनली प्रॉम्प्टेड बाय साध्य और एंड
एका लोकेशना एव यम यम एका एव लोकेशना.
सो लोकेशना, सो डिजायर फॉर लोक इज रियली ओनली वन डिजायर.
अतः त्रिधा व्यपदिश्यते.
एंड देयरफॉर वन एशना अलोन इज एक्चुअली डेजिग्नेटेड इन थ्री फोल्ड वे.
सो द टीका या पुत्रेशना इत्यादिना त्रिधा उक्ता सा यम एका एव लोकेशना इतरस्य तत्प्रयुक्तत्वात् इति योजना.
बिकॉज अदर टू,
सो इतरस्य अतः इतरस्याः तत्प्रयुक्तत्वात्.
सिंस अदर टू,
सो इतरस्याः तत्प्रयुक्तत्वात्. या
सो द अदर एषणा इज प्रॉम्प्टेड बाय द साध्यैषणा. देयरफॉर रियली स्पीकिंग देयर इज ओनली वन एषणा अलोन.
सो व्हाट इज कॉल्ड पुत्र एषणा एंड व्हाट इज कॉल्ड वित्त एषणा, नथिंग बट द एषणा फॉर फल लोक.
सो गोइंग बैक टू भाष्य, एक ऐषणाया लोकेषण सा साधन मंत्रेण संपादन न शक्य.
सो सिंस दैट ऐषणा और द डिजायर फॉर एंड कैन नॉट बी फुलफिल्ड अनलेस वन टेक्स अवे मीन्स, एंड देयरफॉर देयर अराइज़ अ डिजायर फॉर मीन्स एज वी डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर.
सो फुटनोट 3 इति नहि साध्यस्य साधनं विना स्वभावाद् उत्पत्तिः.
ए साध्य द एंड कैन नॉट अराइज और कैन नॉट बी क्रिएटेड अनलेस साधनम इज देयर.
स्वभाववाद निरासात, there is a स्वभाववाद which doesn't accept any reason for things to happen, that's all.
So when we accept a cause and effect relationship, that every phenomenon is always connected with the cause and effect relationship, if this is our premise, then the effect is sadhya and the cause is sadhanam. But there are some who say that things are there because they are there. That's called स्वभाववाद. Why is the world there? It's there. Why did something happen? It happened. That's the nature of things. So it's nature of things to happen. But we do not accept that. Even the nature of thing is also because of something.
Vishasmad vatav pavadayan.
So there is a reason. There is a niyamaka because of which the thing behaves the way it does. And so for everything, a cause is accepted. Except for the final cause, which is the substratum for everything.
So satyam jnanam anantam brahma.
Why is satyam jnanam anantam? Because that is what it is. So that's the final cause. But everything else in the creation is because of some cause or the other.
Svabhavavad nirasat.
Since we do not accept svabhavavad, that it is the nature of things that for them to behave like that.
Atah sadhyanusari sadhanam ishtavyam.
Endeavor, one has to take up the sadhana or means that is in keeping with the sadhya or the end.
Id abhiprayakam. उभेहि इत्यादि वाक्य में भाव है.
सो दैट्स अभिप्राय और दैट इज द इंटेंशन ऑफ दिस वाक्य ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ श्रुति.
उभेहि एते एषणे एव भवतः.
बिकॉज बोथ, नाउ दिस बोथ इज साधन एषण एंड साधन साध्य एषण. सो बोथ ऑफ देम आर नथिंग बट एषणास विच अल्टीमेटली साध्य एषण.
Therefore, Bhashya said, साध्य साधन भेदेन उभे ही मीन्स यस्मात्.
ete eshane eva bhavatah. So whether it's sadhyeshana or sadhaneshana, both of them are nothing but eshanas. Tasmat, so what is the lesson to be learned from this? Tasmat brahma vidah nasti karma karma sadhanam va. That is an important lesson. Edam vaitam atmanam viditva brahmanah putreshanayasya vittayashanayasya lokeshanayasya vitthaya atha bhikshacharyam charandi. Brahmanah vitthaya bhikshacharyam charandi. That brahmanah is brahmavit. So, that sannyasa, so vyutthanam is taken in a primary sense. That he has totally grown out of all the desires, that is only possible when brahmana means brahmavit. Therefore, a knower of Brahman. Then Bhashyakara of course will say that even the person who desires to know Brahman also doesn't have to perform any karma. Then what to talk of the one who knows Brahman? So tasmat brahma vidaha nasti karma. Since all the three eshanas are denied in case of a brahmana, where brahmana is understood as brahmavit, then these three eshanas are really two eshanas, karma and karma. Karma is a sadhanam and then means. So karma karma sadhanam va. Since the brahmana does not have to achieve any loka anymore, therefore, so brahmavit can also be taken in twofold way, either one who is aparoksha jnanam or even one who is paroksha jnanam. Even both of them are free from eshanas. Therefore, karma or karma sadhanam. Since karma is not there, because you have to do something or undertake karma to fulfill a certain desire. Since the desire is not there, karma is not there. Since karma is not there, you do not require a sadhanam to fulfill karma, perform karma. Because to perform karma also some sadhanam is required. Jaya me syat, atha prajaya, atha vittam me syat, atha karma kuruya. So you must have jaya and the putra and vitta, all of these you must have in order for him to perform karma. Therefore, since he doesn't have desire for loka, therefore there is no need for him to have karma. And since he doesn't have to perform karma, therefore jaya, putra, vitta, none of them is necessary for him. So nasti karma, karma sadhanam va. Now Ananda continues, prayojaga jnanavatah sadhya sadhana rupad samsarad viraktasya karma tat sadhanayo asambhave sakshatkara uddeshya phalidam sanyasam darshayate. Prayojaga jnanavatah, we are talking about prayojaga jnanavatah, one who is possessed of prayojaga jnanam, meaning paroksha jnanam. So one who is possessed of even paroksha jnanam, as we say, have been saying, that even paroksha jnanam also, an intellectual conviction also, is quite adequate to release one's mind from every desire. Because every desire is born of aviveka. Every desire for something that I do not have is born of, or every desire, let us say, to make myself free or happy or free from sadness. So that desire is necessarily born of ignorance. And aviveka, not only ignorance, but aviveka means lack of discrimination. Or a false apprehension, or a false estimation of things. A false estimation of myself, and a false estimation of everything. So that alone brings about a desire. By viveka, in viveka or discrimination, there is a right estimation based on what the scriptures reveal, and therefore, that very ground for the desire doesn't remain even for the one who has paroksha jnanam. Which means that a seeker is not an ambitious person, there is no ambition there, and there are no aspirations at all. So as Krishnamurti would say, ambition is something that comes in the way of one's evolution. It does. Any kind of an ambition or aspiration is something that is an obstacle. Because that alone then it preoccupies me completely. So here is a person free from any ambition or any aspiration at all. That can only be there when in reality I am already what I am seeking to be. Otherwise no one can become free from aspiration. So they will say you should not have aspiration, but they will not tell you why you should not have aspiration. And lots of conflicts are there. The reason why you should not have aspiration is because you are what you are seeking. So this clarity is found only in Vedanta, nowhere else you will find. So you will find people's statements which seem to say something close to what is being said here, but the clarity is not there. The clarity with which it is said in Vedanta is not found anywhere. And so brahmana or even a mumukshu does not have any aspirations. An aspiration is totally opposed to spirituality. That kind of spirituality we are talking about.
So an aspiration of some material achievement has nothing to do with spirituality, is there habitually. So when we find ourselves having aspiration, then okay, that's a habitual thing. So since there are what we call habitual patterns, we are built into that, rooted, deeply rooted inside, and so aspirations keep on arising. But to submit oneself to the aspiration would not be right. Because that means that submitting oneself to a material aspiration can only be at the cost of the seeking of that which is already there. Tasmat brahma vidaha nasti karma karma sadhanam va. Then, so one is prayoja jnana vataha sadhya sadhana rupat samsarat viraktasya. So one is prayojika jnanam, paroksha jnanam here. Sadhya sadhana rupat samsara ideshanatra is samsara. So putraishana, vittaishana is the sadhana. And lokeshana is sadhya. So when one is virakta or has grown out of all the three ishanas, which means that one has become virakta from the samsara of the nature of sadhya and sadhana. Sadhya sadhana rupat samsarat viraktasya. Virakta means one who has grown out of the raga and dvesha, is called virakta. One who has grown out of the desires. Karma tat sadhana yoho asambhave. See, this person cannot have karma, meaning there is no use for karma. He finds no use of karma, and therefore there is no use of karma sadhanam. So whatever is required to accomplish that karma. Karma tat sadhana yoho asambhave sakshatkaram uddishya. Phalidam sanyasam darshayati. So now that one is a mumukshu, and they were free from these desires, therefore what is the uddesha? Sakshatkaram. So, first level of vedanam is parokshajnanam, ultimate level of knowledge is aparokshajnanam, this is called sakshatkara. So sakshatkaram uddesha, keeping in mind the sakshatkara, phalidam sanyasam darshayati. And therefore, the sanyasam. So keeping in mind sakshatkara, when you keep that in mind, sannyasa or renunciation of all the actions is something that happens. So something that is a phala or something that is a result of that viveka. The idea is even paroksha jnanam also leads to sannyasa of the nature of vividisha sannyasa. So sannyasa ataha iti. Vashyakara says, ataha ye atikranta brahmanah sarvam karma karma sadhanam cha sarvam deva pitru manusha nimittam yajnopavitade tenahi daivam pitryam manusham cha karma kriyate Nivitam manushyana ityadishrutehe ataha vidusham karmadi asambhavat. Since for vidwan, even for a mamukshu, since there cannot be karma or karma sadhanam, therefore yadikrantaha brahmana etam vaitam atmana vidva brahmana so eshanayaha vyutthaya. So Upanishad reports to us that this is what the earlier brahmanas did. Yadikrantaha brahmanaha, those brahmanas of the past, those mumukshus of the past. And so, kuru karma eva tasmatvam purvaihi purvataram kritam evam jnatva kritam karma purvaihi api mumukshubhi. Of course, there is a different thing, but as Lord Krishna also refers to the purvai, meaning atikrantaha mumukshavah. So here Arjuna, how the mumukshus of the past, they undertook the karma knowing that ultimately one has to grow out of karma. Therefore you should perform karma. Meaning that the seeker at the present, so present day seeker, follows the trend that is already set by the seekers of the past. Karma hi samsiddhim asthidaha janakadayah. So Janaka and others, they by karma alone, by action alone, so they attain the siddhi, they attain moksha. Of course, then in the context of karma, Lord Krishna says to Arjuna how he should follow also the example of the mumukshus of the past. Here it is the other way around, that how the seeker should follow the example of the mumukshus of the past and give up karma. Ataha yatikrantaha brahmanaha sarvam karma karma sadhanam sarvam. All the action, all the rituals And whatever is required for the means of ritual, which is what? Yajnopavitadi. So Yajnopavitadi, the sacred thread, and then Shikha, the tuft. So all of these are looked upon as, are unknown rather, not only looked upon, they are definitely means for performance of Vedic rituals. So you are not qualified to perform Vedic rituals unless these basic things are there. Sarvam deva pitrumanushavinimittam yajnopavitadi. Tenahi devam pityam manusam chakarma kriyate. So footnote number 5 and footnote number 6. Adina shikha grahya yajnopavita means also includes shikha, means a tuft. In footnote number 6, tenahi ityadi yajnopavita adinahi devam karma homadi pityam shraddhadi manusam cha danaditi vivekaha. Only when one is yajnopavita and shikha, so that is when he can perform that daivam karma, which is homadi, homa, etc., can only be performed by that person. Pitram shraddhadi, shraddha, etc., also only can be performed by him. And manusam cha danadi, even dana and the karma, which is performed for the manushyas. So threefold karma, the karmas directed to the propitiation of these three entities are there. One is the karma, the rituals performed to propitiate the devatas, then the rituals performed to propitiate the pitrus, and the actions performed to propitiate the human beings. So that is how daivam, then pitru, daiva, pitru, and manusa nimittam karma. So tenahi daivam pitryam manusam cha karma kriyate. Only when one is yajnopavita shikha, that means one is actually baptized as in the Christian, so equivalent of baptism. There they pour water on you, etc. And so that's how it was done with Jesus Christ first. And that is why every Christian has to be baptized. So Jesus Christ was made Christian. So when he declared, everybody realized that he was a wise man and he was what he was, then that water was poured on him. But anyway, so here it is the Yajnopavita, so Upanayana ceremony, which involves both Yajnopavita as well as shaving the head and keeping a tuft. And so that is why Bhashyakara says Yajnopavita and all these things must be given up. Yajnopavitadi. Says Anandagiri, अतिक्रांताः ब्राह्मणाः किं प्रजया इत्यादि प्रकाशिताः किं प्रजया करिष्यामः. सो किं वै प्रजया करिष्यामः, व्हाट डू आई वी हैव विद द प्रजा. द प्रजा आल्सो इंक्लूड्स कर्म एंड वित्त. सो येषां नः अयम् आत्मा अयम् लोकः. सो दैट विल बी सेड लेटर ऑन. इट विल बी सेड एज फुटनोट नंबर 8 सेज इन 4422 दिस विल बी सेड. सो देयर there is a report of what the earlier brahmanas did. Kim praja karishyamah? What use do we have for the praja progeny, for those of us who want only atmanoka? Idi prakaya atikrantaha brahmanah kim praja ityadi prakashitah. So those brahmanas of the past who are actually revealed by the statements of Upanishad, that this is what they did. Tesham karma karma sadhanam cha yajnopavitadi nasti di purven sambandha. So karma karma sadhanam va nasti. So then for them there is no karma or karma sadhanam. So karma sadhana is yajnopavita. Karma is karma, ritual, and karma sadhanam. So that which qualifies you to perform karma is of course wife for many karmas. But then brahmachari also performs a few karmas like samidhadanam, etc. For that also he requires yajnopavita and tuft. And so, yajnopavita dinasti iti purvena sambandha. See, Anagiri, deva putra pitra manusha nimittam iti visheshanam vishadayati. What do you mean by deva pitra manusha nimittam? So, Bhashyakara himself explained, tenahi devam pitra manusham cha karma kriyate. So, vishadayati clarifies. Then Bhashyakara quotes, Nivitam manushyanam itya. This is all purupaksha. No, this is not purupaksha. This is says how yajnopavita shikha required for performing the karma. So when you give up karma, you must give up this also. All the insignia is the same. So this is nothing but like a flag, that declares who I am. So whatever we wear on our forehead, the way we have our hairstyle, the way we dress, all of these in fact reveal what we are. Swami Vivekananda says, you know, that in India, the mark on the forehead reveals what the person belongs to. Whether he is a Vaishnava, he is a Shaiva, he is what kind of Vaishnava, what kind of a Shaiva, everything is revealed by the very mark that he wears, because it's a unique thing. And so, that mark is required. It was considered to be a necessity or a requirement that everybody must have a mark to reveal what they are. So today also the old-fashioned sadhus or mahatmas, they will not, even women when they come before them, without any mark on the forehead and things like that, they don't like it. So they ask them, come, jump, chalo kariya, you know, and so all that stuff must be there. And anyway, so this is how mark must be there. And men also must have a mark, women, everybody must have a mark that declares what they belong to or what they are committed to. So what they stand for. Then you know how to deal with the person also. But you know he is a Shaivite. I am a Vaishnavite. Then you know how to relate to him. Or in Shaivite also is a variety, this variety of Vaishnavite also, this variety. This Swaminarayana is a Pushti Marga, is this, that, whatever it is. Then we know how to relate with each other also, or whether to relate or not, or whatever we want to do. But that mark reveals or declares what that person is. And this is beautiful. And so, it is necessary that this mark or what we call insignia must be there. So, footnote number then, Nivitam Manushyanam Ityadi Shrutehe. Then Anandagiri says, Prachinavitam Pitranam Upavitam Devanam Iti Adi Shabdarthaha. So, Nivitam Manushyanam Ityadi Shrutehe. That Adi Shabda means that this is. So, prachinavitam pitranam upavitam devanam nivitam manushyanam. That means that one is performing daiva karma, or the karma that is directed to propitiating devatas, then how the yajnopavita should be? When one is performing karma directed to pitrus, how it should be? And when one is performing karma directed towards propitiating human beings, how the yajnopavita should be worn? Yajnopavita should be worn in different ways. Then look at footnote number 7. Nivitam manushyanamadi manushyodeshaka dhanadi karma sambandhi brahma sutram yajna sutram nivitam kuryadityartha. So manushyodeshaka dhanadi karma sambandhi. So when one is performing karma, such as dhanam, giving gift or charity to the human beings, this is also called brahma sutra. What is called? So yajnopavita also is called brahma sutra. There is brahma granthi. Yajnopavita for a brahmachari usually has 3 threads, because that shows this connection of the 3. A connection with the Lord, connection with the Guru and connection with the scriptures. These 3 connections are shown, and the knot is called Brahma Granthi. Brahma also means Veda. He is committed to Veda and he is qualified to study the Vedas. So Brahma Sutram, Yajna Sutram, also Yajna Sutram it can be called, but that is for Grahastha. A Grahastha, he wears a Yajnopavita having 6 threads, because then the 3 threads are for his wife. And then he is qualified to perform Yajna Yaga. Yajna Sutram Nivitam Kurya Rityartha. What is Nivitam? That also is explained subsequently. Ev Uttaratrabi Arthaha Anusandheyaha. And then similarly, what is Prachinavitam? When performing karmas for Pitrus, then Prachinavitam. Performing karma for Devas, Upavitam. And performing karma for human manushyas, Nivitam. So, Atra Amaraha Upavitam Brahma Sutram Prodhade Dakshinekare Prachinavitam Anyasmin Nivitam Kantalambidam Vidhi. So everything, Amar has to say about everything, you know, Amar Kosh. Atra Amaraha Upavitam Brahma Sutram Prodhade Dakshinekare. That Brahma Sutra is called Upavita. When Prodhade Dakshinekare, that Tika explains, Dakshinekare pod prodhrade bahishkrade sadi yad brahma sutram tat upavitam idi uchade. So when dakshinakara, when the right hand is excluded, so when you wear the yajnopavita, when the right arm is excluded, that means that you wear yajnopavita from left arm onward, so that is called upavita. Dakshinekare prodhrade mean bahishkrade sadi. Sadi saptami. So then that is called Upavitam. So
So the Yajna Sutra or the Brahma Sutra or the sacred thread worn that way is called Upavita. Prachina Vita Manyasmin. When it is worn in the opposite way, that means instead of excluding right hand, you exclude left hand and wear this way, then it is called Prachina Vitam and Nivitam Kanchalambitam. And when both the hands are excluded, then that means Kanthalambitam. You wear it when it is hanging from the Kantha, from the neck, it is called Nivitam. So that's what Tika explains. Dakshinekare Prodhade Bahishkrate Sadi Yad Brahma Sutram Tav Upavitam Iti Ucchare Vamaskandharvitam Iti Avata. The idea is that when the Brahma Sutra or the Yajna Upavita is worn on the left shoulder, it is called Yajna Upavita. Then Prachinavitam Anyasmin. Anyasmin means what? Vamakare. So Vamakare Prodhrate, then Brahma Sutram Prachinavitam. So when the left hand is excluded or kept out, then that Brahma Sutra or Yajna Upavita is called Prachinavitam. Samanamanyat Kanchalambitam Iti Karadvaya Bahishkrute. When both the hands are excluded, Bahishkrute Kanthe Malayava Rujibhavena Arpitam. So one wears, so many people wear like that, you know. So because the parents force them to take this, you know, wear Yajna Upavita, they don't like it. They are opposed to it, you know. In fact, there are children who are just opposed to that. They are opposed to whatever their parents want them to do, because they are opposed to parents or whatever it is, but anyway, they just don't want that. And so, if they are forced to wear them, they just wear it like mala. So, declaring that, I disagree with you, you know, that is rujubhavara. But anyway, that is called nivitam. So apparently, this is how one should wear the Yajna Upavita while performing dana, etc. This is what some shruti says. Nityadi shruti hai. Okay. Now, say the Anandagiri. Yasvat purve vichara prayojika jnanavanto brahmanaha virktaha sanyase tat prayuktam dharmam anvatishthan tasmat adhunatanovi prayojika jnani virkto brahmana tathakurya dityaha. Yasmat, since purve vichara prayojika jnanavanto brahmanaha. Purve brahmanaha, in the past, these brahmanas. So, vichara prayojika jnanavantaha. Brahmanas or the mumukshus possessed of a knowledge. Which knowledge was that which prompted them to perform vichara or inquiry? In short, they were possessed of that kind of knowledge or discrimination which actually prompted them to make an inquiry about the nature of reality of life. Everybody is possessed of some knowledge because of which everybody performs some kind of inquiry anyway about the world. But when one is possessed of a knowledge which prompts one to perform the inquiry about the nature of reality, what's the nature of reality? Who am I? Who is God? So when that becomes a preoccupying thought or preoccupying desire to know, so vichara prayojika jnanavantaha, possessed of the knowledge which is vichara prayojikam. So prayojika jnanavantam means what? Vichara prayojika jnanavantaha. So those who are possessed of the knowledge that actually prompts them to deliberate upon the scriptures, study the scriptures. Brahmanaha, those Brahmanas of the past. Viraktaha, they were viraktaha, they were free from all the desires. Sanyasya, that means they gave up all the actions. So, vihita karma. Tat prayuktam, dharmam anvatishthan. Tat prayuktam meaning what? Sanyasa prayuktam, dharmam anvatishthan. Then they took up a way of life which was prompted by sannyasa. It was compatible to sannyasa. That is what? Footnote number 8. Shravanadirupam, bhikshadirupam cha. So although they say bhikshacharyam charanti, it is not that bhikshacharanam is the only duty of a sannyasi, is the only thing that a sannyasi does. So tat prayuktam dharmam anvatishtan. Sannyasa prayuktam dharmam. Dharmam is what? Shravanadirupam, bhikshadirupam cha. Shravana, the main dharma is shravanam, mananam. So, main is to go to teacher, approach the teacher and live the life of an antevasi and devote oneself to the study of the scriptures. By study we mean actually the reason why you study the scriptures is not just to become a scholar, you have to study the scriptures for one's spiritual growth, that's all. Meaning one who is committed to one's spiritual growth, inner growth, and scriptures are the means of that inner growth. Your other scriptures are signs, that's a means for outer growth, and here is a means for inner growth. And that's the purpose of studying the scriptures, not for becoming a scholar, etc., which he may become in the process anyway, not that he will not be, but that is not the purpose. Purpose is to study the scriptures in order to bring about that transformation in oneself. So therefore, one is committed to a life of bringing about one's own inner growth or transformation. So that is called Tat Prayuktam Dharmam Anvatishtan. Since there were those mukshus of the past, who actually, anvatishtan meaning, those who performed that dharma, undertook the dharma or what was to be done, so way of life, or not only way of life, but then the values of life, which were conducive to fulfillment of that mumukshatvam. Tasmat adhuna tanopi prayojika jnani, therefore even the modern day prayojika jnani, modern day the one possessing that jnanam, this even aparoksha jnanam, vyaktaha brahmana tatha kuryat. So a brahmana is discovered vairagya. So primary qualification for sannyasa is vairagya. So vyaktaha brahmana tatha kuryat. If word brahmana can be understood in terms of jati, or brahmana can be understood in terms of any contemplative person, tatha kuryat, that brahmana also should do that. And so since a brahmana, so that way you can say it is bhutarthavadaham. This is a statement of what happened in the past. That this is what the brahmanas of the past did. Thereby the Shruti says that brahmanas of the present day also should do that. That's the purpose of bhutarthavada. So arthavada is basically prompting one to perform, or to do something that is enjoined. So always something that supports the vidhi. To bring out the qualifications or bring out the good points of what is to be done, and bring out the opposite, if you fail to do that, this is arthavada. And bhuta arthavada is kind of an arthavada, where they resort to the presenting of something that happened. So, when you, arthavada, so when you resort to something that happened in the past, just as when you want to prompt your child to go to school, you say, see what your uncle did? So your uncle went to school and this is what he did. So bhuta arthavada. He has no interest in what his uncle did. But the purpose is, see, this is what you do, then you can also do, become like that. And that is how arthavada also indirectly actually is meant to enjoin something. So even though here we do not find a positive statement that one should necessarily take sannyasa, but Shruti resorts to what we call bhuta arthavada, stating here what the mumuksha of the past did, and how then they attain the fulfillment of their life, therefore the mumuksha of the present day also should do that. So a vidhi or an enjoinment is contained in that, is in a veiled sense. A veiled vidhi is there, if not in a open or a clear sense, in clear words. This is the interpretation of this vakya on the part of Bhashyakara, that this is a vidhi or an enjoinment for sannyasa. So viraktaha brahmana tatha kuryat iti aha tasmaditi. Since this was so, therefore tasmad, Bhashyakara says, tasmad purve brahmanaha brahma vidaha vyuthaya karma bhya karma sadhane bhyascha yajnopavitadi bhya paramahamsa parivrajyam pratipadya bhikshacharyam charande bhikshartham charanam bhikshacharyam charande tyaktva smartam lingam kevalam ashrama matra shananam jivana sadhanam parivrajya vyaktam vyanjakam. Tasmad, therefore, purve brahmanaha brahma vidaha vithaya karma bhya karma sadhane bhya yajnopavitadi bhya paramahamsa parivrajam pratipadya. So,
So Purva Brahmana, the Brahmana of the past, Vithaya, having become free from the desires, Karma Bhya, Karma Sadhane Bhya Vithaya, giving up the karma and therefore the means of karma, Yajnopavidadi. So Yajnopavidadi Bhya, Karma Sadhane Bhyascha Vithaya. So Yajnopavida, etc., which are the sadhanam or the means of karma. Yajnopavida is not a means of karma, that way of life. Yajnopavida is an insignia which means that one should lead a certain way of life. That way of life also is to be given up. So when one gives up karma, one should also give up the way of life that is required for karma. That is also understood. So you give up karma all right and then retain the way of life of grihastha, that won't work. So way of life also is given up. Because grihastha is there, then karma also perform. Brahmachari is there, then that whatever karma also perform. So when karma is given up, all insignias are given up. That means that the way of life also is given up. So vithaya karma bhya. Yajnopavitadebhyah karma sadhanebhyascha vithaya. Paramahamsa parivrajyam pratipadya. Taking to the life of Paramahamsa parivrajaka. Paramahamsa means one who has grown out of every kind of an insignia or any kind of an attachment or association. And one who is a parivrajaka. So that means a mumukshu also becomes a Paramahamsa parivrajaka. Actually Paramahamsa parivrajaka is generally a designation that is used for only Brahmanishtha. But here, Paramahamsa Parivrajyam Pratipadya. The idea is that one has no commitment other than the scriptures, that's all. Because when you take up any other kind of sannyasa, then some or the other kind of duties remain. In sannyasa, other than Paramahamsa, so Kuti, Chaka, Hamsa and other sannyasis, they are all required to perform certain specified or prescribed duties. Though they may be of the nature of worship, etc., Bhashyakara says even that is not required. That you must necessarily take bath so many times and do this kind of japa and this kind of... All of that also, even those kind of restrictions are also not there for a Paramahamsa sannyasi. This is the idea. That means giving up every kind of restriction. Because they may interfere with your commitment to the pursuit of knowledge, and therefore giving up any kind of restriction which may become an obstacle or come in the way of the pursuit of knowledge. The reason why Bhashyakara says is that then this person is totally committed to the pursuit of knowledge, nothing else. Therefore, Paramahamsa Parivrajyam Pratipadya Bhikshacharyam Charanti, says footnote 1, Shravanadi Sheshakale Dehasthityartham.